This program was paid for by Water of Life Church. From Water of Life Ministries in Plano, Texas, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob is speaking through his servants to the world. He that hath ears to hear, let him hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying today. Let us join Doyle Davidson and others of Water of Life, sowing the Word of God in spirit and in truth.
Hello, I'm Doyle Davidson, servant and apostle of the Lord Jesus Christ, ministering locally to the body of Christ in Dallas and Fort Worth, Texas, sent by God to your house to declare to you the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. 1 Corinthians 15:3-4 tell us what the gospel is, how that Jesus Christ died for our sins according to Scripture, he was buried, he rose again the third day according to the Scripture. Spirit of the Lord's upon me. He's anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor, sent me to heal the broken heart, preach deliverance to the captive, recovering the sight to the blind, set at liberty them that are bruised. The word is nigh thee, and in your heart, and your mouth. There's a word of faith, so I preach, you confess with your mouth, the Lord Jesus, believe in your heart that God raised you, and from the dead you shall be saved. With the heart, man believeth unto righteousness. With the mouth, confession is made unto salvation. I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. There's a power of God unto salvation. Everyone who believeth, to the Jew first, and also to the Greek. Therein is the righteousness of God revealed from faith to faith, as it is written, the just shall live by his faith. Thank God. Amen. Hallelujah. I want to welcome everyone receiving this broadcast on live stream, Roku, Apple TV, YouTube, and other devices. Oh, and shortwave radio, right?
Amen.
Sure enough. Have on to my left, Kathy Davidson, thank God, co-host. Good evening, and how are you?
Doing well.
And to my right, Brian Bonnet from California to Texas.
Amen.
Right. And he's co-host, and how are you?
I'm doing well.
Amen. Amen. All right, folks. You know, sometimes you have to get tough with you people. Jesus got so tough, he made a whip out of small cords, and he went in the temple. The temple. Yeah. And they were changing money and such, and he whipped them good. Did you know that your body is a temple for the Holy Ghost?
Amen.
Did you know that? Did you know the Bible says you should pray without ceasing?
Amen.
Yeah. Do you do that? No. I can tell you you don't, and I can tell you why. Because of what I'm saying. God is not just happy with a bunch of you people, not just few, more than a few. And that's what you do. You play games. Well, I don't play games. And this house doesn't play games. And God will certainly visit a people that plays games in my house. He did it once before. And in 2004, he turned the power of darkness loose on this house, and it went down, 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 down. And they were scattered every direction. You think you couldn't be scattered? You think you're exempt from that kind of treatment from God? Do you think you're so holy that Jesus just has to take care of you? Ha ha. Now, 2 Corinthians 12. We're not going to read it. I'm going to tell you what it says. It says, and you can take the Bible yourself and read it. You can take this chapter. But Paul was at a messenger from Satan to to buffet it. Sent by Satan to buffet it. And thank God, he sought the Lord three times to get that off of him. Lord told him his grace was sufficient. His grace was sufficient. Are you hearing me? His grace was sufficient because he said, your strength is made perfect in weakness. Perfect in weakness. You say, I'm weak and I'm weary. Good. I'm going to show you how to get out of it.
Amen.
Grace. Grace. Not, oh, I'm so weary. I'm so tired. I'm so weak. I'm such a mess. There's no hope for me. If I could get rid of my husband, if I could get rid of my wife, if my children weren't so mean, well, all might be true. I don't know. Might not be. But the Apostle Paul, God told him that his grace was sufficient for his weakness. For his weakness was made strong. His strength was made perfect in weakness. Yeah. Now, and he said, your grace is sufficient. That's all you need. You don't need anything else. Well, didn't he? Can anybody deny that what I'm teaching is true or say, oh, no, he told him to read 500 Psalms an hour. You know what I've learned? Apparently, reading the Psalms has little effect in this place. I don't understand that one. But grace is sufficient. In your weakness, grace is sufficient to make your weakness strong.
Amen.
Are you there? No. Now, talking on the telephone to somebody, I only weakened you. You know that? Listen to somebody cry about their problems and you pet them sad. That don't admit. That don't admit. You know, once a guy called me, he said, I'm having trouble. I said, you do? Yeah. You are? Yeah. What's your problem? I don't have any money. Now, this is a long time ago. I don't have any money. I said, you read any Psalms? You read any New Testament? No. I said, read the Psalms out loud. He said, all I can do is cry. I said, read the Psalms out loud until you quit crying. Man, he didn't know what to do. One day he called me. He said, well, I've read the Psalms out loud, and I'm not crying. Don't have any money. I said, good. Read them out loud until you get some money. Now, you know what? I'm bringing you to a new level of gospel. Hebrews 4:16 says, let us come boldly to the throne of grace that we might obtain mercy to find grace to help in the time of need.
Amen.
Need? You have any need? Well, what do? You come boldly to the throne of grace. To obtain mercy. To find grace to help. Now, folks, I'm not going to play your silly games. I'm going to tell you, till you listen to me, I know what I'm doing. How many of you have walked holy with God since 1970. Yeah, nothing but God. But I haven't. So, I believe it's Matthew 15, 10, that doesn't sound right, talks about grace. Can you find that? I am what I am, Paul said.
That's Acts.
Huh? 1
Corinthians 15.
Thank you.
Where?
1 Corinthians 15.
Well, didn't I say 15?
You said Matthew. Okay. Oh, it's verse 10. But by the grace of God, I am what I am. And his grace, which was bestowed upon me, was not in vain. But I labored more abundantly than they all, yet not I, but the grace of God, which was with me.
Amen. So it is, 1 Corinthians 15. Get it right, Noel.
You had everything right but the book.
Yeah.
Well, that does no good. That makes me a false teacher. And I repent. All right. Now, would you read that again?
All right. It's verse 10. It says, but by the grace of God, I am what I am. And his grace, which was bestowed upon me, was not in vain. But I labored more abundantly than they all, yet not I, but the grace of God, which was with me.
Now, do you labor more than anyone? Do you? Do you speak mercy, grace? Mercy, grace? Or you get on the phone, call somebody and tell them how great they are? Now, I'm going to tell you, you can speak mercy, grace, mercy, grace, mercy, grace, mercy, grace. It'll work. It will work. The grace of God in you. Is it work? Is that right, Katie?
It says the grace of God which was in me, yes, which was with me.
And it did more than he did. Is that right?
It says, right. He said, but I labored more abundantly than they all, yet not I, but the grace of God which was with me.
Okay. The grace labored more than everybody.
Right.
Amen. Well, I'm doing that. No question about it. But let me tell you something. You're going to learn how to speak grace and mercy.
Amen.
It's not that hard. And when you're weak, you better get to speaking it. Grace, mercy, mercy, grace. Grace, mercy. Do you think this is a game I play? Did you know I left a lucrative practice of veterinary medicine to come here at the direction of God? And I came without any money. I came to this town without any money, any salary. And I met some people, and they said, we want you to be our pastor. And I listened to them, and I said, I'm not going to be your pastor because you don't have a church. Oh, were they infuriated. That 165 people got together, and none of them knew anything about God. None of them. They talked big game, act like big game hunters, but they didn't know anything. So they finally decided to join me. I said, all right. And they had a meeting, and the leaders had told them that I said I would not listen to any man with the Lord. 165 people, about 100 of them left that meeting and never came back. Good riddance. But was, I'd need them. That's the only thing about God. They'd want to learn. Everybody, guess what? I survived. Why? God sent me. Guess what? I'm here because God sent me. Guess what? I'm here to bear fruit because God told me to.
Amen.
I didn't come here to preach to you and listen to you espouse a false doctrine. So pay attention to what I'm teaching you. At this time, women, children, everybody, start speaking. Mercy, grace, mercy, grace, mercy, grace. And watch what happens. Watch what happens. Are we ready?
Amen.
Heard some songs?
Praise God. Hallelujah.
You are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people, that you should shout.
Rejoice in the Lord. Oh,
Blessed Redeemer, My name is the mighty name.
6 minutes.
Well, good. All right. Now, I'm going to help all of you if you want help. I'm going to give you some quick help if you want help. And they're Terry Mai's tapes. Played all night while you're asleep. My faith and anointing is on his tapes. Every one of them. Now, I don't have problems since I finally got the sound equipment straightened out. I play Terry Mai's tapes all night. You can play them all, but there's a couple, Rise and Be Healed, I'd pick out. Rest of them, for you, they're good. Amen? El Shaddai's not the best, but it'll help you. They won't keep you awake if you're sleepy. Katie, can you tell them what I run these at?
Loud.
Too loud for you.
No, I sleep in them.
Well, you're doing well. But when I raised them up, you thought you couldn't do it. But they'll keep you awake. But I'll tell you what, they won't keep me awake. Faith is there. Anointing is there. And I get up and I feel great. And it's true, some nights I pray from 2 to 5 or 6. But you don't do what I do. It'd be nice if you did. Sure help me. But I can tell you, your faith will get there if you want it. You'll have to do it every night. It won't hurt you. I don't care what sound specialists say. I pay no attention to them. I have to survive, and I do. So you can do it if you want to. If you think you're cool, you're a fool.
Amen.
You are. You're a fool. Listen, I had one terrible time bringing this place out of the pit. Terrible. Starting in 9, it was bad. But I kept fighting. I kept fighting. I'm coming out. But see, I was in deep darkness. Deep darkness. You are too. You just don't know it. Hebrews chapter 4:2, I think. The gospel was preached unto them as well as unto us.
Amen.
But they did not mix faith with it.
Right.
And it did not profit them. Now, there's faith with Terry Mai's tapes. You may think you're a great person of faith, and you might be greatly deceived. You never met a man that could talk like I do and survive. Did you know I'm taking up one offering in all the years I've been in Plano? That was an offering God said, tell him it's my offering. And I did, and I got $23,000. I needed $75,000. But God came through, paid for the place where they could foreclose it. I don't ask for money. Nobody knows how much money I need, and you won't. Amen. I'm coming out of darkness, folks. I'm coming out. Not for you, with your help. Because you're not helping. You can't even help yourself. Amen. It was tough on the way to this building tonight.
30 seconds.
Amen. Why? The people of the world not paying attention to God. I've just told you how you get help. And help the church. Help me. Sure.
15.
I want you to do it. I want your help. I don't want your doubt and unbelief pouring all over me.
Amen.
Amen. Thank God. Amen. 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 Are we out?
We're out.
We're out. God bless you.
Amen.
See you tomorrow, 11 o'clock. Give you some more. Wait.
Amen. Praise God.
We invite you to visit Water of Life Church at 1621 18th Street in Plano, Texas. Or for further information, call area code 972-578-8082. That's 972-578-8082. Or write Doyle Davidson, Post Office Box 861327, Plano, Texas 75086. That's Doyle Davidson, Post Office Box 861327, Plano, Texas 75086. This program was paid for by Water of Life Church.